With the pandemic in full swing, I found it difficult at times to maintain an enthusiastic approach to practicing. With no concerts looming in the near future, not a performance deadline in sight, gone is that delicious, nerve-wracking understanding that the clock is ticking and I only have 2 months, 2 weeks, 3 more days to prepare and perform X. In an attempt to spice up my own practice, I decided to try something the other day and I found it so enjoyable that I wanted to share it with you. So I humbly invite you to accept today's practice challenge, which is to take any one aspect of cello playing that you already do well, something you feel extremely comfortable doing, and spend today seeing if you can make it 5% better. It can be anything, vibrato on third finger and fourth position, drawing rich open bows on the D string, or creating gorgeous resonant pizzicato notes, anything. But the challenge is to improve something you already feel confident doing. As adults, I think we tend to focus and fixate on improving our weaknesses. It makes perfect sense, of course, but I wanted to try turning things upside down for a change. So take a break from pushing those Sisyphean boulders up the hill as usual and try enhancing something you already feel good on. Personally, I'm gonna spend today working on bow changes. They aren't the first thing that comes to mind when I think of my weak spots, but I'm preparing some pieces with long, sinuous melodic lines that stretch out over many bow changes, and I wanna see if I can get closer to that ideal goal where if you close your eyes, you wouldn't be able to tell when I change bows. And in case you're not sure what you should work on, I'll just share a little bit of my practice with you and describe what I'm attempting as I go. Maybe it's something you'd like to work on as well. So there's a few ways to do bow changes on the cello. What I've been working on in my own playing is focusing more on kind of the paintbrush technique that I believe Leonard Rose introduced, at least to Americans, and he learned that from Ivan Galamian, a very famous violin pedagogue. And so the idea of the paintbrush stroke is that you want to prepare in the fingers and prepare the arm like as if you're doing a paintbrush. As you're finishing the stroke in one direction, the arm is already getting started on the next part of the stroke, and that kind of helps create a seamless transition between the strokes instead of just moving and then stopping directions and going in the opposite direction. That's the theory, at least as far as I understand it. So what I've been working on is developing kind of a preparatory finger motion that helps me get into that position. So if this, let's say this is my up bow position with my fingers, so I'm, you know, moving up bow, and then let's say this kind of tugging this way would be more my down bow position, I want to get into that down bow position just ahead of actually pulling down bow so that you don't hear kind of a big click as my hand flops over and, you know, it doesn't disturb the line. So that's what I'm going to work on right now. I'm taking a small run from the Sanson, the Swan. Any run of notes is fine. I'm just focusing on bow changes. So what I'm going to do is pull down bow, and then at the end of the down bow, I'm literally gonna stop the bow, prepare the hand for the up bow to remind myself that I wanna be in up bow position ahead of time, just ahead of time. Okay, so that's gonna look like this. And then now I'm ready for up bow. Now down bow. It may seem counterintuitive, like that's going to actually put a hitch into my bow stroke or create some weird kind of hiccup, but I found that by focusing on that, it actually does smooth my bow changes out. So I'm going to do it one more time. Thank you. right, now I'll just try the run, see how it feels. So another way to kind of tackle this concept is to take a piece, I'll just take a piece from one of the Suzuki books, actually, from book one. It's French folk song, and I'm just going to play, you know, the first four bars or something. So the point of doing that is I don't want to think at all about the notes with my left hand. I only want to focus on the right hand and really trying to create a beautiful sinuous connection between each bow change. So let me just demonstrate what, hopefully it will sound great for you, okay? So there's my challenge to you. It's pretty fun and I've gotten some good results with it already. If you choose to accept today's challenge, please leave a message below telling me exactly what you decided to work on, because I'd love to know. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please consider doing so. I'd really appreciate it. Thanks so much.